صباح الخير، النهارده هنبدأ أول محاضراتنا في الأورال ميديسين 4، وهنبدأ بموضوع Ulcerative and Vesicobulous Lesion of the Oral Mucosa. وهنلاقي في موضوع Ulcerative and Vesicobulous Lesion some topics أو some disease you study before in the oral medicine. At the beginning, after appear in oral mucosa, like these people, all have red color, but we knew what we need to differentiate between them through definite or differential diagnosis, which disease to better treatment. So we need to differentiate between ulcer, and so we have many classification in ulcer vesicobulous disease. We must know at the first what is ulcer and what is appear in oral mucosa. Ulcer is loss of epithelium layer, part of epithelium before the connective tissue or may reach the connective tissue. So ulcer, loss of soft tissue epithelium, loss of epithelium may be due to trauma, autoimmune disease, infectious disease, and so on. This defect extends to connective tissue or not. If extended to connective tissue, pain will be severe and bleeding. It is ulcer. And this is clinical appearance of ulcer. But occlusion is loss of part of epithelium, not total layer of epithelium. So occlusion is partial loss of epithelium, which appear red lesion. This occlusion may be, as I say, trauma. This trauma may be mechanical or thermal. Also, in some time, this occlusion may be due to rupture of vesicle or bulla. This is occlusion. As we see, it is not extended to connective tissue. It still is epithelia, so it's partial loss of epithelia. And this is clinical appearance for occlusion. Here, this is clinical appearance of occlusion. Of course, occlusion have some pain, but not severe as ulcer. As I mentioned, occlusion may be due to rupture of vesicle or bulla. So we need to differentiate between vesicle and bulla. Vesicle is elevation lesion. It's a plaster containing clear fluid, but it is less than 1 centimeter in diameter. It is vesicle elevation, which may contain clear fluid. This is clinical appearance of vesicle, while bulla also is elevation, but this elevation, which also contain clear fluid, is more than 1 centimeter. This meaning bulla is larger than vesicle. This appearance of bulla, and this is clinical appearance of bulla. As you see, the border of bulla, I change the color to another color. This is bulla here. This is border of bulla. As I say, it's contain also clear fluid, but it is more than 1 centimeter. In the picture, you see the people wear red coats, and I say they all like ulcer, and I need to diagnose between this ulcer. To reach a better or good prognosis, you must take history from the patient, and this history including what factor local occur, what systemic background, and history of this lesion. Also, you need clinical examination to observe the border and the floor and the base of this ulcer. And finally, if you don't reach a proper diagnosis, you need laboratory investigation, which may be blood picture examination or test for any systemic disease or biopsy for this ulcer. Information need which help you to proper diagnosis, you need to know the history of this ulcer. And this history include length and time of this lesion. If this lesion appear once, or meaning acute, or it's a chronic. Also, if this lesion appear, how long they stay? Sometimes patients say this ulcer is appear acute or chronic or recurrent and may stay for 10 weeks, 10 days and disappear. You need to do if there is acute, chronic, recurrent and how long they stay. Also, you need in history of this ulcer, you must need information about its primary or secondary. And we will know what's meaning by primary ulcer or secondary ulcer. Also, you must observe number of ulcer, single ulcer or multiple ulcer. All of this information must be taken in the history from patient before clinical examination. So, oral ulcer may be chronic, acute, recurrent, or maybe primary and primary or secondary, or single and multiple. For that, they made classification of oral ulcer, and this classification may be depend on first duration recurrence of oral ulcer, or this classification may depend on ulcer primary or secondary, or classification according to etiology. So I have three different type of classification of four oral ulcer or oral vesicular bolus disease. This classification according to if this ulcer single ulcer, you will ask about our search about traumatic ulcer, malignant ulcer, or infectious ulcer, mostly bacteria and fungal ulcer. All of these cause single ulcer. If this ulcer is multiple, we will ask patient about duration, acute or chronic. If this multiple ulcer and the chronic, it may be like planus, lupus, erythematosus, pemphigus vulgaris, herpes simplex. Even this ulcer, if multiple but acute, sudden appear, it may be viral, erythema multiforme, or ulcer to you, secondary to allergic or acute necrotizing ulcerative. If this ulcer is recurrent, it occur and disappear and occur again, it may be what's called recurrent herpes simplex or recurrent abscess ulcer or Behcet or Reiter disease syndrome, Reiter syndrome or Behcet syndrome. So this classification of ulcer according it single, multiple, and if it is acute, chronic, and recurrent. Another classification according to, as we see, acute, chronic, multiple, and single. Okay, and this classification, which we'll discuss in details. What about primary ulcer or secondary ulcer? Primary ulcer meaning this ulcer is appear ulcer from the first at the beginning, while primary ulcer which ulcer preceded by vesicle or bulla. This meaning I have bulla or I have vesicle, this bulla and vesicle rupture leave ulcer or leave occlusion, so it is secondary ulcer because it's preceded by vesicle or bulla, while primary ulcer which appear from the beginning at the ulcer. This ulcer, secondary ulcer, may be secondary which preceded by vesicle. This secondary ulcer which preceded by vesicle again may be intra-epithelial ulcer or sub-epithelial ulcer. This meaning to formation of bulla or vesicle, this meaning I have generation or breakdown in the epithelium. So if it breaks down in the epithelia, it's called intra-epithelial vesicle, which may be acansulitic or non-acansulitic, and we'll discuss this again. Or vesicle may be at the baseline and separate epithelia from connective tissue. If the vesicle or bulla formed at the baseline a basement membrane. A basement membrane and separate connective tissue from epithelium, that's meaning it is sub-epithelial bulla. So again, vesicle formed, which will be ruptured to form secondary ulcer. This vesicle may be formed intra-epithelial in the epithelial layer, or formed at basement membrane to separate the basement membrane with epithelia from connective tissue, which is called sub-epithelial bulla or sub-epithelial vesicle. This is classification of oral ulcer according to its primary or secondary. As we see, secondary, which is preceded by vesicle, divided to intra-epithelial, like herpes zoster, herpes simplex, herpingina, and pemphigus vulgaris and derrière, while secondary sub-epithelial, which vesicle formed and separation of epithelia from the connective tissue, like pemphigoid and the bullous mucous membrane pemphigoid, receive multiform, and like implanus. As I mentioned, I have another classification according to etiology. What is the cause? The causes of this ulcer is physical or chemical agent, like traumatic, thermal, chemical, electric. So it is called reactive ulcer, okay? Or maybe due to microbial agent, which may be bacterial, viral, or fungal, or this ulcer due to neoplasm, immunological reaction, this autoimmune disease or immunological reaction, or ulcer due to blood disorder, like Kissing anemia and neutropenia, or sometimes occur ulcer due to gastrointestinal disease like ulcerative colitis, which is common gastrointestinal disease causes oral ulcer, or sometimes drugs like cytotoxic drugs and chemotherapy may cause oral ulcer. So now, classification of ulcer depends on the etiology, depend on primary or secondary ulcer, depend on acute, chronic, recurrent, single, or multiple. Now, we will study ulcer in patient in case of acute lesion, acute ulcer, and multiple. So, patient with acute, multiple lesion. Now, we study patient with acute, multiple lesion. First one is viral infection. The most common viral infection we will study is herpes simplex virus. Now, we give idea about viral infection. Later, we will discuss herpes simplex. To know viral infection, we must know what is property of virus and what is composition of virus and how virus enters the tissue. And if virus enters the tissue, what is response of tissue towards the virus, any virus. Now we know that virus is a very small size, which about 10 micrometer to 300 micro. Virus contain what's called genome, and the genome which carries the genetic format of the virus may be DNA or RNA. Okay, also what about metabolic inert of the virus? We know that virus can multiply only inside the living cell. Virus don't live outside the host, so it cannot be metabolically and multiplication in outside. Virus always need host cell to survive, to metabolic, to reproduction of another virus. What about entry of virus? How virus to the body? Virus can enter the body by four main routes. Maybe through inhalation, and this affects mainly respiratory tract, as virus corona, COVID-19, which is present now. Virus can enter the body through ingestion, and it will affect gastrointestinal tract, or through incubation, from the skin. Especially this skin or mucous membrane has abrasion or erosion, have ways to enter through the skin. So incubation by contact through skin, mucous membrane, Well, this is example with sexual transmission viral infection or through transfusion of blood, injection of drugs. So it can incubation entry of the virus. Also, virus had another mode of entry, which is congenital, from mother to the fetus, through the blood or through delivery. What about virus structure? Mainly virus, as I mentioned, have a genome, as this genome carry the genetic information of the virus, which may be DNA or RNA, and is have a cuspid and envelope protein to cover the outer surface of the virus. This is called virome. And envelope may be form inclusion bodies which can see in biopsy. This structure of virus, as I mentioned, this DNA or genome, this genome of virus and DNA inside, and this cuspid, which is protein sheath covers the virus. This is what is cuspid, okay. And this is another shape of protein. Inside you found RNA and covered by protein. Another shape of virus, you will find this DNA, and this is envelope. This is envelope. Protein covers the virus. This is example of virus structure and virus shape. Again, it has genome, which has nucleic acid, cuspid with protein coat, and envelope, which lipoprotein covers the virus after the cuspid. Now, genome, protein, lipoprotein. What effect of virus on cell? Now, we know shape of virus, structure of virus, route of entry of virus. What about after entry? Virus inside the host cell. What will happen to this cell? After virus entry the cell, what happened to cell? Number one, cell may have insusceptibility for this virus and don't give the virus chance for metabolic reproduction. So the virus will be die and can't penetrate cell. Or virus causes cytotoxic effect, kill host cell, or maybe remain latent inside the cell until weakness on host immune to release. So need external stimulus. So it is latent infection, not cause infection at once. Sometimes virus causes in cell some change, causes cell as a body recognize this cell as a foreign and causes immunological reaction to this cell, what is called autoimmune disorder. Again, virus may causes a change inside the cell, causes this cell recognized by host as a foreign body, and the host will form autoimmune antibodies to this cell. Or virus may change in cell and causes what's called transformation to change this cell to cancer cell. And this is most important. Again, virus entering cell may cause change in this cell. May cause change in this cell by change in structure and transformation to cancer cell, or let the body recognize this cell as a foreign cell, and this causes body will form antibodies to this cell and what is called autoimmune disorder, or it may remain latent in the cell and do not appear infection until external stimulus appear and cause infection, or may causes cell to this host cell, this lehan, kill host cell, or virus can't penetrate and the virus will be die because the cell don't give him a chance to reproduction and metabolism. Virus growth cycle. What happened in the virus cell? After absorption on the host cell, they will enter to the plasma and penetrate the cell. What is happening? Use the cell for replication and transection. Replication for repeated number of virus. By direct the host cell, it will direct the ribosome energy and enzyme in the host cell to synthesize viral component. So virus, so cell act for the virus. For the virus through cell ribosome energy and enzyme, because virus has no enzyme and has no ribosome and has no enzyme, just DNA. So direct the cell toward formation of enzyme and energy and size of viral component. After that, what's called assembly. Assembly meaning that formation of new virus. DNA virus will be assembly in the nucleus of the host, while RNA virus will be assembly between the nucleus and cytoplasm. The virus produce many DNA and RNA from the nucleus or cytoplasm of the host. It will be released from this cell. So it enters the one virus and it is released from the cell of host many virus. Rupture of this cell and release of this virus to start a new cycle. Enter new cell and also direct cell to form its viral component. After that, it will be released again to many virus. This is virus cycle, as we see in this picture. This is number one, virus enter the cell, but it is when it enters the cell, as you see, it not totally enter the cell, only the DNA or RNA which enter the cell and leave the protein outside the cell. This RNA or DNA it go toward the nucleus, and make ribosome and enzyme in the cyst cell to forward many formation of many virus, as you see here. Formation of many RNA or DNA virus from the cell. And when it is released, every DNA or RNA will form from cytoplasm, form it a protein, cover this RNA, as I say, in assemble. Assemble meaning use cytoplasm of the host cell to formation protein code for the virus. And rupture of cell, release of many virus, each contain RNA or DNA, and code by spike protein and envelope lipoprotein. This is life cycle of the virus, any virus. Also, virus may have common clinical appearance. Common clinical feature in virus, viral infection must be preceded by prodromal sign and symptoms. These prodromal sign and symptoms include fever, headache, measles, nausea. Anyone have influenza, before the sign appear, he feel some of headache. The body is breakdown, weakness for muscle. This is what is called prodromal sign and symptom. After that, vesicle will appear, and this vesicle will be ruptured, especially in oral mucosa due to good presence of saliva, and leave an ulcer. Okay, ulcer followed by pain due to exposure of connective tissue and the nerve ending. This patient will be suffering from excessive salivation, and this saliva will be loaded with virus, contain a lot of virus. So when you speak or cough, the droplet spread, which is contain virus infection. Sometimes in many disease is self-limited disease. It's appear and complete curing after 2 weeks, months, according to host immune. So this is common clinical feature of viral infection. Maybe change in some virus, but it's mostly a common feature, clinical feature. Now we will talk about treatment of viral infection. And we must remember viral entry, no sign will appear the first days. But clinical sign appear after 2 to 3 days. In these 2 to 3 days, the number of virus will increase more and more. What about sign of treatment of viral? The first, it may be mild sign. Mild sign meaning slight measles, headache, fever, need to bed rest, liquid diet, and high nutrition value, analgesic, and antipyretic if there is any change in temperature, and aura based to relieve the, or prevent the trauma for this ulcer. Also, sometimes you can use mouthwash, antibacterial antiseptic, or antibiotic tablet, not for treatment of viral infection, but for prevent infection for this ulcer. Secondary infection for this ulcer. This is antibiotic, antiseptic, not for treatment of ulcer, but treatment of ulcer and viral infection need antiviral drug. Antiviral drug like acyclovir, 100 to 200 or even 400, 5 times daily for 5 days. To control replication of virus, to control replication of virus, to inhibit DNA replication. But once the virus entry, it will be cause sign and symptom. I think antiviral to control and inhibit replication. And in severe case, we can use interferon injectable form. What about corticosteroid? Doctor, corticosteroid is anti-inflammatory. Okay, it may be accelerated healing and decrease the inflammation, but it also corticosteroid immunosuppressive and will decrease the body resistance and decrease body immune response. Sometimes it may be led to spread infection and increase the viral infection. So corticosteroid not used in viral infection treatment because it is decreased body resistance. As I mentioned, virus may have maybe contain genome DNA or RNA, and depend in different in manifestation and disease. DNA virus, the most common DNA virus is herpes virus. The family of herpes contain a lot of virus like herpes simplex, varicella zoster, Epstein-Barr virus, cytomegalovirus. All of this is family of herpes virus and causes many of disease. For example, herpes may cause acute herpetic gingivitis, recurrent intraoral ulcer, recurrent herpes syphilis. Varicella zoster may cause chickenpox and herpes zoster. And the Epstein-Barr virus we studied before, it causes hairy leukoplakia, but also causes what's called infectious mononucleosis, Burkitt lymphoma, nasopharyngeal carcinoma, and so on. Another family is papillomavirus, which is most common human papilloma virus. And this human papilloma virus causes oral warts, oral papilloma, Hodgkin disease, condyloma, acuminata. Also DNA virus, Hibadana virus, example is hepatitis B virus. This is DNA. While RNA virus contains another family like paramyxovirus, retrovirus, antivirus, and picoronavirus. Picoronavirus, example hepatitis A and hepatitis C. Okay, this RNA and DNA virus. Now, we have idea about virus structure, middle of entry of virus, life cycle of virus, what about clinical feature of virus, treatment of viral, now, and know what type of DNA viral and RNA virus. Now, we will start study. The first one is herpes virus infection. Herpes virus infection, again, is DNA virus. This herpes is a large family, contain many viruses. Have about 80 known type of herpes virus. 8 of them causes infection to human, like herpes virus 1, herpes simplex 1, herpes simplex 2, herpes simplex 3, herpes simplex 4, and one of them has the name. This virus until 5 causes oral manifestation. Virus after infection, it's not curable, but virus will transport from the mucosa or skin to the nerve ending and passes in the nerve ending till reach ganglia and remain latent in this area. No replication state, it remains latent until, as I mentioned before, this latent virus may be resist for long period, may be resist all the life, no again reinfection, or any time have reduce your immune, it will be again activated. So it will be reactivated, not raw reinfection. Reactivated because it is latent. It's stay in the ganglia. And when reactivated, recurrent of infection. So it is called recurrent infection, not reinfection. As I mentioned, we have herpes simplex 1 and herpes simplex 2. This is table 4, compare between herpes simplex 1 and herpes simplex 2. Herpes simplex 1 mainly causes oral infection, while herpes simplex 2 mainly causes genital infection. Also, herpes simplex 1 causes ulcer or dermatitis, infection of the skin above the waist, and 2, dermatitis below the waist. Herpes simplex 1 causes pharyngeal and meningeal encephalitis infection, while herpes simplex 2 causes infection to newborn. Infection to newborn or neonatal with herpes simplex 2 appear due to contact of newborn with vaginal lesion appear in the mother. And the infection with infant are asymptomatic. However, sometimes maybe appear infection to the causes jaundice, hepatosplenomegaly, thrombocytopenia, if there is complication and it is appear in the 4 to 7 days of the life. However, herpes simplex 1, it's important for us because it causes oral manifestation, so we'll study herpes simplex 1 in details. And herpes simplex 1 causes 3 diseases. The first is primary herpetic infection. This primary meaning it's first infection. And when it is recurrent, it causes recurrent herpes labialis or recurrent intraoral herpes. Primary herpetic infection, as I mentioned, it's primary herpetic gingival stomatitis, appear primary infection, and appear mostly in the children, and to have no immunity, no formation of antibodies, and it may be have local or systemic manifestation according to immune response. Sometimes same virus enter to 2 persons, one person have slight headache and another person have severe infection with lymphadenopathy and fever, okay? It depends on the immune response of each one. Herpes simplex recurrent meaning the primary infection. This recurrent causes, as I mentioned, recurrent herpes labialis or recurrent intraoral herpes. meaning reactivation, not reinfection, because the virus was be latent virus. What doctor causes of activation of virus? Stress, trauma, fever, exposed to sunlight, hormonal alteration. Okay, so some people each winter have recurrent herpes, which is called بالعربي يقولوا نطر برد على شفته. It is not نطر برد, it's activation of virus, herpes virus, which is latent, but with stress or fever may be appear. Some person with each exam due to stress have reactivation of viral infection. Okay, in case of recurrent, we will have high antibody titers, increase of antibodies. In primary, we have no antibodies. And maybe, as I mentioned, maybe have systemic in primary manifestation, but in recurrent, I have no systemic manifestation. Now we will talk about the primary. We compare between primary and recurrent. Now we will study the primary in details. In primary, it mostly occurs in children from 1 year to 10 years. Okay, sometimes we say that this child is a pair of teeth. No, it is due to herpes. Have measles, fever, excessive salivation. It may be herpes infection. Okay, as mentioned, clinical feature of virus all share about prodromal symptom which appear 1 to 2 days before the ulcer or vesicle appear. Nausea, vomiting, lymphadenopathy. After that, the viral appear clinical features which are vesicle eruption, and this vesicle will be subside. This vesicle appear in keratinized and non-keratinized, and very important, herpes systemic or primary herpetic gingival stomatitis appear in keratinized and non-keratinized mucosa. This vesicle will be ruptured due to presence of saliva and our mechanical irritation and leave a occlusion or a small ulcer. So this ulcer is secondary ulcer. This ulcer is a small, round, shallow, surrounded by inflammatory area around it. Also, infection may spread to the eye. If you touch this ulcer and go to your eye, infection will be spread to eye, genital, or skin. And it is called herpetic white law, and it is common in dentists. As I mentioned, clinical feature of ulcer of herpes is salivation. This salivation and the ulcer will be stay for 7 to 14 days and it is healed. So virus acute herpetic gingival stomatitis is self-limiting. Acute herpetic gingival stomatitis is self-limiting. Of course, as I mentioned, may stay for 14 days and it is relieved and healed. What occur in tissue in this viral infection? Number one, we say I have a vesicle. And this vesicle is intraepithelial vesicle because it is in the epithelia, not reach the basement membrane. And this vesicle formed by destruction of cell, destruction of prickly cell. So it is a tensolysis, destruction of cell. And we will find what is called multinucleated giant cell. Cells, large cell have multiple nucleus, and we will find the nuclear inclusion body, which in the affected cell due to presence of viral and inclusion body, viral enter the cell and leave the envelope outside the cell. These form nuclear inclusion bodies, and after cell degeneration, we will find ballooning degeneration of cell, ballooning degeneration. So when we take biopsy, in case of viral infection, we will find destruction of prickly cell, which is called acantholysis, due to formation of intraepithelial vesicle. And we will find multinucleated giant cell, nuclear inclusion body, and ballooning degeneration of the cell. This is a characteristic feature of pathogenesis of viral infection. Diagnose and the treatment. Diagnosis from the history and the clinical examination. And sometimes maybe need special investigation like smear from the fresh rupture vesicle. We can do pathological smear or do a culture. In culture, we will isolate the virus. Pathological smear will stain by thing called germs stain. And this germs stain will appear inclusion bodies which is characteristic of viral infection. Also, we can estimate the antibody state with PLA high. And treatment, as I mentioned, in mild case, bed rest or a base, sometimes mouthwash antiseptic, in severe case, need systemic antibodies and cyclovir. Laboratory investigation, as we mentioned, we can scrap the vesicle to form smear and stain by germ stain. We can in biopsy show multinucleated giant cell inclusion body and the periodic degeneration of the nucleus. Also, we can estimate the antibody state in absent antibody, that's meaning antibodies not detected in the first week, but it detects antibody high at second week. Okay. This is case of primary herpetic simplex infection. And it is, as I mentioned, it appears in keratinized and non-keratinized. This is recurrent herpes lipiensis. Recurrent intraoral herpes in keratinized mucosa. Again, recurrent intraoral herpes. Herpes simplex in tongue. Oh, this is child herpes simplex. And this is inclusion bodies which appear in virus. This is inclusion bodies in the outside the cell, or not in the cell. It is inclusion bodies from the envelope of the virus. It remains between the cell. Herpetic white law. As I mentioned, viral can spread to the skin or finger and causes what's herpetic white law. And this occurs finger of doctor and nurse and doctor like dentist. If you examine any patient without gloves or cut off the gloves and expose your finger to saliva of the patient, if your skin has any laceration or ways to enter the virus, it will cause herpetic white law. As I mentioned, it appears by itching and pain in the finger. No vesicle appears at the first 2 days, just itching and pain, which is called prodromal sign. After that, deep vesicle will appear, and it is limited in 19, 18 to 20 days. The lesion is self-limited, but you need precaution. If you see this swelling and vesicle, don't try to incision. If you think it is abscess, don't incision by scalp to avoid the spread of the infection or secondary infection. Okay, so always use gloves or wear gloves, use rubber dam. It's essential to protect yourself. This example, and this example of multiple vesicle, as you see, multiple vesicle and the swelling in the nails, multiple vesicle, this herpetic white law. What about recurrent herpetic lesion? Lesion recurrent is like first, the primary, okay, it may be similar to the primary. As I mentioned, the virus remains latent until reactivated by stress, common cold, exposure to sunlight, immunosuppression, allergy, hormonal disturbance. The cause can reactivation of the site of the virus. The virus appears again, prodromal, burning. But then followed by vesicle formation, this vesicle will rupture and leave the ulcer, and also it's self-limited in 14 days. Pathogenesis like primary, and the treatment also by use of some local or palliative treatment and bed rest, liquid and good nutrition, and in some case you can use antiviral. Also, recurrent intraoral, the same vesicle, formed intraoral, it may be uncratinized or non-cratinized. Ulcer characterized by a regular due to rupture of vesicle surrounded by erythema and pain, heal with 14 days. This example of recurrent intraoral herpes. Recurrent herpes labialis. Herpes labialis. This is also under the skin area between nose and the lip. Again, that's very clear vesicle appear, very clear vesicle appear before rupture, and it is ulcer intraoral. Sometimes you say that's cold sore plaster. It's called sore plasters. And this is after secondary infection, the plaster is ruptured and leave ulcer, and this ulcer have secondary infection. Thank you.